Good evening, sir. So today we are going to present our final year project, Melanoma Detection by Deep Learning and with Convolution Neural Network. And here are my teammates, Amrita De, Doipan Bhattacharya, Arindam Choudhury, and myself, Kamala Chakraborty. So first, this is our presentation and this is our subject details. So in this content, we are going to see the introduction about the disease, that is melanoma, and melanoma by detecting by deep learning. Well, accuracy of the model that is yet to be improved, and conclusion, and also the related work that's previously done based on the topic. So introduction, definitely, as we know, skin cancer is very deadly and also dangerous if it is not diagnosed at the proper timing or the correct time. And it is basically generates or originates from the melanocyte cell of epidermis. And we are here basically trying to develop a model with the help of deep learning. And that model will predict whether the given data set of images are, whether it is consist of melanomas or not. So that is we are going to detect. So next. So we are now first looking to the details of the disease, what is the disease or what is about it. So how to identify whether it's melanoma or not? So there is some five features are there. So if anyone has this type of things, then that person can must go to a doctor, because these are the few things that we have to look after, look for. That is, first, the affected area is A for asymmetry. This is the mnemonics of the skin cancer melanoma. That is A for asymmetry. Most of the time, the affected area is asymmetric in nature, I mean in shapes. Then border. Border is melanoma. Borders are absolutely uneven, and it is basically notched the edges at the edge to edge triggered, edge to edge spatially. And C is for color. Color is not defined. Color is depend as per the melanin and the skin tones, the amount of the melanin present on the skin, and also based on the skin tones. D is the diameter. The affected area's diameters are also important, because that is not more than 6 millimeter. And E is for evolving. That is changing in size, shape, within how much of time it is growing and taking a big shape around it. That is the main thing. And this is the way, this is the basic mnemonics of ABCD of melanoma, that the way we can detect the whether it's melanoma or not. This is the very first symptom that we have to observe, and you have to go for a doctor. Next, melanoma overview. As we say, this is very dangerous, and if we don't take care at the proper timing, if we ignore it, like saying that it's a birth mold, then it can be deadly, and also life can be put on risk. So basically, it is originates. It is different types. It can be it can be ancestral. I mean, this is genetically. It can be passed. It can be from sunburnt ultraviolet ray. It can affect also from that, or extremely less melanin. Basically, we are saying extreme fair skins, also very melanoma prone skins. Causes of melanoma. There are lots of causes for melanoma. First of all, whenever we have extreme sunburned skin, or we are wearing some sleeveless, very exposed, we are trying to expose our body parts, then it is very, especially in the sun, morning time or in the noon time, that is where the sun is very scorching. We are having a very scorching heat or scorching suns in that time. It is very tough, and it is very tough for the skin with that, to fight with that UV ray. And for sometimes it's a person can have a melanoma for this type of wearing sleevelaces and all. And also it can be genetically passed, like DNA in skin cells are also contained in melanoma. I mean, less melanocytes or melanin in the skin. UV radiations are also, like the people who lived in Africa, Peru, Uruguay, those are the very heated country. And there are the people have mostly, I mean, maximum of those countries have sunburned people who their skins are sunburned. And also those countries are not so rich. Those are their main... occupations are agriculture. So for that, they in those cases, the almost 90% of the cases are out of that area particularly. Next, risk factor. So these are the basic risk factor of the skin. There is those who have fair skin, though that type of persons can have melanoma rather than a normal skin tone, because in their cases pigmentation of the skin and the melanin is very less. So that is, and that can be a bigger melanoma prone skin, we can say. A history of sunburn, those who have very sunburnt skin, exposed area with sunburnt, that places can also have a melanoma. Excessive ultraviolet ray light exposure of UV radiation, just like we know, so that can also harm our skin, and it can make the skin cancer. And leaving the closure to the equator or a higher elevation, right? Because this type of the areas which is are very closer to the equator, those have the, I mean, sun actually give lights there absolutely perpendicular, so it is the most hottest area we know, and that type of that's why those the people on who lives near the equator, they had mostly records of skin cancer. Next, how to prevent melanoma. So these are the basic, like, we have to step out with umbrella. That is the basic way to cover the sun or avoid the sun, not completely, but the basic way to avoid the sun, that is umbrella. Use sunscreen. Sunscreens have some SPF 30 type things that can protect your face skin from sun. That is very important. And wear full sleeves. Obviously, for the entire body part, we have to wear full sleeves. Full sleeves is very important. And at the same time, it will reduce possibility of having a sunburned skin on hand, on legs, or any parts of our body. Use sunglasses. Now, here is different or interesting thing, that why we use sunglasses, because this is a melanoma skin cancer, and the skin is going to be affected. But no, this is the interesting thing and also the dangerous thing. It's not only the skin of our body, but also the skin of our outside of the eyes and inside of the eyes. Outside of the eyes, like our eye crease, our upper eyelid, lower lid, and also this crease part and of our eyes, and the inside part like sclera, cornea, iris, this type of part is going to be affected very badly. There is also melanoma happened. So we have to be very careful, and we can prevent this melanoma skin cancer, just this lady can do, like completely protecting yourself from sun, and be very careful about it. So now we are going to the how we are detecting with the help of deep learning this melanoma cancer. So first, the background, it is becomes, with the help of deep learning, it is basically, morality rate is not that much, we can see in 30 years, but now this is the basic, we're developing model that can, any person can have or access the treatment for doctor very less amount of time, and because more time will take, the more the risk will grow. So this is the background, okay. Then the methods, basically we are using convolution neural network methods, basically those, and to develop this model. And this is absolutely, here we can see there is a dermoscopy image out there that we are taking as a input data set. Now those, the total image is divided, first it is an image, then it is divided into some sub images, small images, so it's not, I will not say pixels, but it's small images. And then the resized, it is one of 12 patches, it will resized, and then with the help of convolution network, it will pass through some steps, and finally we are going to have the output. Now we are going to see the technology stack, that is, we are using Python. This is basically the language is being Python, because it's a very easy to understand and easy to write language, and also so that's why we are using Python in deep learning. Basically PyTorch we will going to use, because it's absolutely computational and also very helpful to use PyTorch in deep learning for building this model. And NumPy Panda is also we are using here. Basically these are the basic modules that we are going to use. Next, steps of detection. Now how can we detect a model? So when we are having a model that we are going to detect, so first there is some test steps that we are taking some input data, and not only it is not just small data set, we are taking some huge 3 GB data set we are taking, suppose, and then we are taking that data set, and in our model, first this data set is going to be read, then we train that model. then we'll train that model, and after training that model, we will validate that model wherever that is validated. We have to check the validation for that data set. Now, after the validation, we will test the model, and after testing, we are getting the output of the model. Now, this is a closed sample. We are just going to close up to a sample. Like here, we can see a normal image that is, that few colored borders are there, and here we can see the zoom, absolutely the clear image of that particular part. So this is a close up of an affected part of melanoma skin cancer. Next. So what libraries we are using in this model? PyTorch, Pandas, Scikit-learn, Scikit-learn, and P-Train model. So PyTorch is absolutely open source machine learning library based on basically Torch library. It is basically used for natural language processing, deep learning, or some model training, some model and computer vision, obviously. Pandas is absolutely aims to be the basically the very high level building blocks of doing practical things like computation, mathematical functions, wherever data analysis, that type of thing. Scikit-learn is a free software machine learning, which is very helpful machine learning, and also you can use it for deep learning. We used in Python programming language, and we know like classification, regression, logistic regression, clustering algorithms, this type of thing we are computing in Scikit-learn. Pre-trained model, basically this is pre-trained model is very helpful that no one have to create a model since from the beginning, but instead of building a model from scratch to solve a similar problem, we can use the model trained on other problem as starting point. So that is more easy for the user who are training the model. Next, now here we are going to see the steps that we are basically our model is going to be going to do. We are taking some image. This is actually the image, or it's a clip of a data set that we are having. This is a small snippet of that. First, we say we are taking like image name. We are going to take the patient ID and the sex, whether it's a female or male, because skin varies. Age approx we are taking. The age is also important. And general, where is the affected area is where it's head, it's neck, it's genital area, where it is. Diagnosis, where the data is going to be diagnosed, and benign or malignant we are going to see. So training a data set. So this is the convolution neural networks that we are going to train a data set. Like from each node, there is, you can see it's a many to many relationships are there. It means we are going to take the samples from each, from one to one, from many to many. Every set there is, they are connected to everything. Also it's a very important part of the artificial intelligence program, because this is called the training data. This is the way we can train the data. And this data foundation is a library of information basically. And without a high quality training without a high quality data, most of the performance of the algorithms are poor, and we cannot accept, or we cannot expect a perfect and error free result. So this is the main important part of training a data set. This is the way we train the data set. Okay, now this is a convolution neural network. Convolution neural network, here we can see just like there are a few steps, and I think from here onwards, I think I ask Doipayon or any one of my team members will say or something if they want.
Yeah, I am taking from here. Hello, we have tried with the KNN and Red Forest. By trying this, we have found that there is not much accuracy. So we have tried the basic convolution neural network by deep learning, and it is at a preliminary phase that we are trying to solve. The first we are taking the input, and then we are passing that input in many layers, and by that we are extracting the features, and then we form the network, which is fully connected neural network, and then we predict the output one by one. And next slide, please. So here the validating data set means a validated data set. Example is tune the hyper parameters that we have to tune. We have to train the data set. We have a training data set that have the valid models, and then that we have to validate that model and then test that model, that how much the accuracy will come. And that is the basically the that way we can predict the that the pictures we are giving of what whether is malignant or benign or not. Next one. This is a training set and test set of data set, and training set have the prediction, two classifications and etc., module accuracy and etc. is there. This is a graph. And next one. This is the final output. This is if after passing the model, we will get this kind of output, and it is malignant, and the this kind of output will be formed. Next one, please. This is the accuracy we are getting now. It is around the 42% to 43%. The total accuracy is 45% around, and we are trying to get the accuracy at the level of 90 to 95% in the upcoming updation. But this is the accuracy where we are now standing. Next. Right. This is the accuracy and previous works that has been done by other scientists, and this is the accuracy of their models, and we are still way far from that. So this is from my side.
We are working hard to achieve that level always. And this are the conditions.
This is from my side, and now Amrita, if you.
Hello. After this, we can say that in this particular project, we have doing our best, and why we should use the deep learning. So basically, in this project, we have used the deep learning because of the deep learning. Basically, in this particular project, in our melanoma skin cancer disease project, we have using the deep learning because of that. Deep learning has a tremendous, very efficient in dermatology department, because it can predicting more effectively and the most safer way to treat the patient. And as the technology has already become very firstly, so we can say that using the deep learning, we can easily testing our data, and the clinical settings can appropriately use in this data set. So what we can say that, we can use the black box testing algorithm in this particular project, and that is all over our project. So next slide. So in this, we can say that here are some references which we have used in this, and with the help of this, so that is all about our project. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Very good presentation. It's a great presentation.
Sir, at the end, we are concluding that basically we are mainly focusing to train our model perfectly. That's the basic 70% chance that we can have a perfect and error-free data. And after that, validation is 20%. And then testing is 30%, we can say that. So these are the basic, the proportion that we are saying. And we are trying to do our best to make our work to achieve at least 90% accuracy. We are trying for that. We know we are so far from that level, but we are still trying for that. And this is our today's presentation.
Probably very good.
Final presentation. Thank you.
Okay. My observation is that your presentation in the initial melanoma detection is very exhaustive. I like it. And I think you can also, a life lesson, that you will be a little bit expert of melanoma detection. You will be careful. So, very good presentation.